This is not just a hot dog cart. This is an alternative to the negative influences that plague the kids in our inner city. And we perceive it as a victory, and we hope they do too.
This victory has been over a year in the making. Concerned parent E.B. Wiltz decided it was time to do something about opportunities for young African-American males and others in the urban core of Kansas City.
I'm very concerned about the state of things for our kids in the inner city and the education that they're getting and how they're going to be able to navigate real life from a education system that is basically struggling right now.
A construction worker by trade, Wiltz invited five young men to work with him on building a hot dog cart. He is paying for the roughly $800 in material costs out of his own pocket.
I thought that there was a lot of lessons that could be extracted from building a cart. I mean, you have 45 degree angles and you can teach them in school, but they never knew how the 245s came in to make the 90 degree angle. So that gives them that relative experience that explains the importance of what happens in a classroom. And we're hoping to do that. We're hoping to take each project and extract as much learning from it as we can.
15-year-old Marquise Keeney is in middle school in the Casey Moe School District. He says that while he enjoys math and algebra in school, this project helps bring some of the concepts he's learning to life.
The measurements and stuff, I learned that in school, but it was fun just learning about it and like doing real things about it.
Cut those two at a 45, 45 is a 90 degree angle.
Beyond this hands-on experience, Wiltz hopes to create a support network for the young men who will make money from operating the cart and help the next group of young men build their cart. He's calling the group Brother for Another.
I'm born in 1960, so I had a chance to live through the civil rights movement. And I know how the community existed during the civil rights movement. So that another is sort of like what I've seen happen. It was just genuinely good people that knew it was wrong. They came in and made a difference. And Brother for Another is what I thought of them, and that's what I think of this organization.
Wiltz says that he feels like the baton of the civil rights movement and a love of education have not been passed to this generation. He's also concerned about violence among young African American men.
When you think of half of a generation dying of violent crime by their own hands, to me, it is it's a tragedy. We're risking losing an entire generation. You know, so I started specifically with that group. I wanted to make sure that somebody was doing something for that group.
Wiltz is focusing on young men around his son's age. Wesley Wiltz is 24, and he has adopted his father's entrepreneurial spirit.
And I just like to be a businessman, have everything on my own. I don't want to have to rely on, but you would have to rely on some people, but I would just rather employ other people and become a businessman of myself.
Brother for Another first debuted their project at the Mayor's Ideas Fair last fall, where Mayor James promised them a spot for their first cart in front of City Hall. Wiltz said this helped fuel their excitement.
The challenge for me has really been just getting the kids to sort of realize, you know, the potential, to sort of realize that this is more than just a cart. This is something that we can rally around and do together that's positive. So the challenge has been galvanizing that idea of collaboration and synchronizing our efforts so that we can further our community.
Later this summer, Brother for Another will present what they've created to the mayor's office and will be setting up shop around town.
And we plan on having the best sausage here in Kansas City. So in the future, you guys could look for the Swamp Thing, which is gonna be the name of these carts, and come out and try our sausage, and I guarantee, like they say in Louisiana, you'll be back, Shane.
Reporting for the Hale Center for Journalism at KCPT, with photographer Dave Burkhart and editor Kevin Lambie, Lindsay Fote.